those massive things you're talking about, and what we said before regarding who's doing what and who's doing the other, and is someone else doing it here and someone else doing it there, I think we can support that as a constituency. But the four areas Dawn's talking about is what the people, and that's what's important tonight, it's what the people want, have fed back to us. Although we've got that data regarding the big issues you're talking about, NEETs, and the whole area around pupil premium and how that's managed and the strategies up in school and manage that, that's for us as school governors and as councillors and constituents to take on together. Well, for a start of the town, I think that's what we're talking about. The feedback from the constituents, from the people that Dawn's talked about, is the most important priority to take on. And then other priorities that you've mentioned, that have been highlighted in there, they're already being done by the council at the moment. That's what I see.
Needs, Bill. Tony mentioned needs.
NEETs is one of these acronyms,
yeah.
Not in education, employment or training.
Okay,
that's what NEETs stands for. Thank you, Harry. Denise.
I mean, my priority at the moment would actually be, I mean, there's no breakdown here, is how many old age pensioners did we lose last winter? So basically, it was 30,000 that we lost nationally. How many in Birkenhead did we lose? And now that is my priority this winter now, is that we're looking after our pensioners, making sure they're all right. If we know anyone who's on their own, we need to go and make sure they're okay and they're warm and have they got something to eat. And if we need to help, we can just don't do that ourselves. But that is my priority for winter now.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks. Certainly Dawn respond to that and I'll bring the colleagues in.
Sorry, I was late, but not totally my fault. And I'm more important.
weapon and look at the data in your head. And I really want to just draw attention to one of the papers, the relevant where I'd like to contribute. If you look at the constituency budget, it's currently sometimes being collected by allocation of population, and sometimes geographic relocation. There's no coming yet, but there's all kinds of them. If you look at the biggest budget, which is page 6, which is waste and environment and health, which is 4 minutes. My proposal might be, as well as obviously paying proper attention to what constituents or organisations say they need, is both better to understand those data, and also, as Stuart said, the use is really useful opportunities you could have to drill down. Both to do something which makes a difference in both things, it's very clear what we've done, but it helps us to understand that they have both aspects. And I'm just amazed about the waste control. It seems to me to be an incredible amount of money. Because we spoke, world study which shows that if you do that brilliant.
bit, but Stuart and Tony.
Based on the previous agenda.
to clarify what Stu was saying. But I just want to come back on what Frank was saying, that's okay. I'll leave it to your contributor. I don't personally think we should spend the money on sending someone into schools, basically, to have a look at where things start and all the rest of it. But the council's already doing that, and as you said at the beginning, right, how many of us in AR school governors? I'm a school governor in primary school in Prenton. I can come and give you a report based on key stage one, key stage two, key stage three, on what the pupil premium is spent on. And that's where that data is. And I can come and give you a report on that free of charge. I'm sure a lot of the other governors could as well. So I don't think we really need to be spending the money on resources that we've already got available.
Well, it's just, I completely agree with what you were saying, and as I said, I don't think, with the greatest respect, that's ambitious enough, and I think we need to set ourselves. First thing is, how much do you have to spend? And I mean, on the entrance thing, I was one of the councillors who was on the phone almost daily, every day, when the contract changed, and we got a big collection of posted in entries. No, I'm not surprised to see that up there. And I'm not surprised that people want to know about it, but that doesn't address the
loudly, I think everyone in the room then, you know, councillors and members of the public. I think the debate is good because we're trying to get to root cause. I would like to take an approach that tackles what makes Birkenhead a uniquely bad place to live. You know, it's got great aspects, but we're here to help people in difficulties. What makes Birkenhead a uniquely bad place to live? And there is data there that says we are different in a number of ways. So we are different. One example is we have the highest population and groupings of ethnic minorities. Birkenhead has found that role, for whatever reason it serves that role. So that's something that's uniquely different about Birkenhead. Not saying it makes it uniquely bad, but is a challenge, certainly, to have that within Birkenhead boundaries. There's also other issues. We are the poorest by a long stretch. So anything that doesn't attack poverty and root cause of poverty. Root cause of poverty is the root cause of anything. Ill health, crime, you name all this. Poverty is the common link. And all the factors play a part, but that is the common link. So I think we need to, perhaps when we've got more time, and we have got the time now, to make a case of what makes Birkenhead uniquely Birkenhead. I think Dave Charles talks about it. The old fire town. Whatever makes Birkenhead Birkenhead, that's what we're here to tackle and change the bad parts that we don't like. We're here to tackle and change as a constituency. So we can take that approach. And what we did for Will in a similar situation, revision of government, we explained what made Will unique, what was unique. We asked four questions of anybody who come for money. Can you tackle those four questions which make Will uniquely bad? And health inequality was one of the things that made Will uniquely different than many, many other borders. The stark divide between this side of the border and the other. So I think we take a similar approach to Birkenhead. I also don't mind this committee doing something really practical early doors. And if there's a crisis in people's back entries and disease and rats and infestation and things that go there, we would look rather silly not to sort of say, it's a problem now, we've got the capacity to make a quick win, let's go with that. And then at the same time, a long-term plan that tackles the priorities that make Birkenhead uniquely different. The other thing I would say, I was quite disappointed to read the paragraph about communications. One thing I think is uniquely difficult and different about Birkenhead, lots of chunks of the population don't get free newspaper, which is often used as the main vehicle to get information to people. We often turn to websites as a solution. And lots of the people we represent won't see a computer from one day to the next, for whatever reason. And we will have to deal with many different languages of Birkenhead if we're to communicate with all of our population. So I think our communication strategy, again, should have uniquely Birkenhead stamp on it and tackle those three major issues in terms of communication. So I think we can make some early doors progress. Those other problems, by the way, have been with us for centuries.